The film is more or less in two parts. The first part takes place in a house in the city of Marrakesh. And there we use Sir Aymer's house, which was a typical Moroccan house, a little courtyard surrounded by rooms, partly on two floors, but most of the action is on the ground floor. So you just have this little courtyard, and off the little courtyard you have the various rooms. And we used that for the film, and that, of course, that filming was comfortable because it was his own house, and there weren't any great problems with neighbours or any great sound. But I don't remember any sound problems. John was able to take synchronous sound perfectly normally there, but with quite a big apparatus. They hadn't invented the Nagra yet, so we had a one inch tape reel to reel. Machine, which it was portable, sort of. If you were strong, it was portable, but only just. I always think the revolution, which is overtaken sound, hasn't happened on the camera side. On the camera side, if anything, the cameras are getting heavier again. But the sound recorder, now you can put it in your back pocket if you feel like it. Anyway, so the first part of the film takes place in that in Marrakesh, in the square, in the souks, in that house, and we were able to work perfectly comfortably and get what we want without much trouble. And then in the story, she falls in love. The heroine, played by Victoria Grayson, falls in love with an Arab who is a musician playing in one of these groups that perform in the square, and he was a flute player, I think, or violin, it doesn't matter, a musician who plays in the square, and she falls in love with him. And then the very sort of inscrutable Arab guide who the Catherine Lacey character uses as a servant, but not permanently, but he's her man. So he arranges sort of clandestine kind of meetings at a wonderful location near the city, which is called the Minara, and it's a little pavilion that sits on a pool, and some of the action takes place there. So he arranges this Arab guide, who's called Ahmed, arranges some rendezvous between Victoria and the Arab, and the young musician, who's called Tayeb. And at the end of each little get together, they just sit together, and he plays her some music, and she teaches him English rather nicely. So he sort of takes her hand and he says, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then he smiles engagingly. Anyway, and then at the end, the little money changes hands again discreetly, and they part, and the thing is repeated, but she falls in the next week, the same thing, but she falls in love with this guy, and then he disappears. And she's very upset, and they don't really know where he's gone. He's had some sort of quarrel with the leader of the group, and he's not there anymore. And there's only one clue. They say he's gone back to his village, and his village, I forget, the name was in my head, but now I've forgotten it. Anyway, he's gone back to his village, and all they have is the name of the village. She's given a piece of paper which has the name of the village on it, and a little drawing of a mountain, a rather sugarloaf-type mountain. And underneath it says, whatever, the name of the village, which I'll come back to in a minute. It will come to my head, probably. It's not important. And she sets off. She steals some money from her hostess, from the Catherine Lacey character. And she arranges with Ahmed, the guide, to go off in search of this boy who's gone missing. And they get further and further and further away from, they're traveling first by bus across a high atlas and then on donkeys. And they get further and further and further away from civilization. And at the end of the film, she is left, he abandons her, and she's left virtually in the desert. She collapses, she's exhausted, and she just collapses on a sand dune at the end of the at the edge of the Sahara, and is then rescued by some local Arab and taken in, and that's the end of the story, which takes place in flashback because it starts at that remote village, which was called what was it called? Not El Arish. anyway, a remote village at the end of the Sahara. And they, and she's left there, and this Arab takes her in.